Well, it's mainly to honour our veterans that participated in the battle and lost their lives. And a lot of them suffered dearly for the rest of their lives. So it's an honour to be part of this, to win and to be remembered.
Just over 70 years ago, on February 19, 1945, 30,000 U.S. Marines landed on the island of Iwo Jima, an island of the Japanese volcano islands with an approximate area of about 8 square miles and positioned south of Tokyo. The goal of the Marine invasion, known as Operation Detachment, was to capture airfields on the island in order to attack the Japanese mainland. The Imperial Japanese Army positioned themselves in heavily fortified bunkers with heavy artillery gunning down U.S. Marines as they pushed forward onto the island. U.S. Marines had little cover as they advanced on the island, and thousands were wounded or killed in the first few days of the battle. Over 70,000 Americans were used to capture Iwo Jima against roughly 23,000 Japanese, with most Japanese refusing anything less than fighting to the death. It would not be until March 26, 1945, the island would be secured by U.S. Marines, and in the 36-day-long battle, American losses included over 6,000 killed and over 17,000 wounded. Iwo Jima was the only battle by the U.S. Marine Corps in which American casualties exceeded the Japanese. 27 U.S. military personnel were rewarded the Medal of Honor for their actions during the Battle of Iwo Jima. Of the 27 medals awarded, 22 were presented to Marines, and 5 were presented to United States Navy sailors, 4 of whom were hospital corpsmen attached to the Marine Infantry units. This was 28% of the 82 medals of honor awarded to Marines in the entirety of World War II in the Pacific. Several local survivors of the Battle of Iwo Jima were honored at the State House in Boston. A few veterans from Hopkinton were also in attendance. In the photo, you could see Rob Phipps, the son of Iwo Jima survivor Paul Phipps, Hank Alessio, U.S. Army Signal Corps veteran, Mike Whalen in the back, a Marine veteran, Pat Lynch in the front, a Marine veteran of the Korean conflict, and Bob Lavoy, a Marine veteran and survivor of Iwo Jima and the Frozen Chosen. Also in the photo, Ed O'Leary, U.S. Army veteran, and Adam Lavoy, son of Iwo Jima survivor Bob Lavoy.
In those 3 days of preparation, each heavy warship was given an area to fire upon. And combined with all the ships surrounding the island, each warship was assigned to fire for a straight 6-hour period on their firing station. Fire consistently for 6 hours, and then they would rotate off, and another ship would rotate in and continue the fire. 24 hours a day, 3 days straight, on a 5x7 square mile island, not bigger than Logan Airport. Every square inch of that island had rounds hitting on it. But guess what? Other than get rid of the foliage, it didn't do much for the defenses. Didn't soften them up at all. Only the historic effort of our nation's Marines, sailors, airmen, soldiers were attached to those three divisions with boots on the ground would be able to unseat those Japanese resistance. And you're looking at 8 of them today.
And all of a sudden, there's a big cheer, and somebody said, "We're raising the flag."